Hi again, everybody. Dom Donnelly with you from Pioneer Field, South Atlantic Conference men's soccer action. As be the 18th ranked Tusculum College Pioneers take on Newberry College Wolves. Wolves enter today's match with a record of 3-5-0, 1-3 in league play, while the Pioneers sit tied atop the conference standings at 4-0 and are undefeated 8-0, including their last win coming back on Wednesday in a thrilling 3-2 overtime win over defending national champion Fife University. So the Pioneers looking to do something that only one other team has done, start a season off 9-0. The Pioneers, this will be the 18th meeting overall between the Wolves and the Pioneers. Tusculum leads 15-0-2. In fact, the Pioneers have won the last seven meetings against the Wolves and are 11-0 all time at home against Newberry. Tusculum won last year's decision 1-0 on October 2nd, 1 year ago today at Newberry. Last time Newberry got a positive result against Tusculum was all the way back in 2008 in a 3-3 draw that on October 4th. So we're underway. The Pioneers in goal for Tusculum will be Jorge Alvarez. In goal for the Wolves, Brad Dixon. Jorge had an outstanding first month of the season, getting 8-0 with three shutouts, 0.98 goals against average. Save percentage of .795 with 31 saves. All right, we got a stoppage in play. Looks like a Pioneer player kind of a little bit of winded. Looks like that's Dallas Dunn, sophomore from Knoxville. Brad Dixon in goal for the Wolves. Started every minute for Newberry. 3-5 record, one shutout. With a 2.11 goals against average with 54 saves and a save percentage of .761. And the Wolves 3-5 overall, 1-3 in league play. Their one league win coming against Coker. Lost 3-0 against nationally ranked Wingate. Last four matches, they're 1-3. Again, all conference affairs. They opened up with a 1-2 loss at Catawba, lost 3-0 at Carson Newman. 1-2-0 against Coker, and then again in their last matchup eight days ago, lost 3-0 at nationally ranked Wingate. So the Pioneers and the Wolves just underway here from Pioneer Field. Glad to have you with us. Trying to go long ways to Linkus. Linkus gathers it in. Georgia's Charkasakis shot is hauled in by Dixon. And back the other way. Linkus goes wide, but a little bit too far for Pop Pedro. Again, Tusculum coming off that 3-2 overtime win over Pfeiffer. Tusculum trailed twice in that match. It's kicked away by Alvarez. Guillermo Lascano sends it long, but that will be gathered in by Dixon. Again, the heroes of the match for Tusculum in that Pfeiffer win. Equalizer scored in the last minute by Jonathan Speaker. Then Isai Hernandez gets the match winner just a couple of minutes into overtime. That sent the Pioneer faithful into delirium with that 3-2 win over the sixth-ranked Falcons. So Tusculum trying to stay hot. Again, off to their trying to start with try to match their best start in program history at 9-0. Tusculum has opened up with wins against King. 2-1 overtime decision at Lees McRae, 4-2 at Lee. Then won in double overtime against Queens. 1-2-1 against Lenoir Ryan. Posted back-to-back shutout and wins at Lincoln Memorial and Anderson. And then on Wednesday's win over Pfeiffer. Nice one touch there by photographer Chuck Williams down on the far sideline, getting all the images, which we will have posted up on our website, TusculumPioneers.com, later this evening or early tomorrow. Always thank him for his service. Here's a long cross. That's to Proven. Sending wide, that's to Georgie. Georgie can't get anything on it, but Went sends it long. Crochelle is dispossessed by Sayer. The Georgie whistle for the handball, so it'll be a free kick from about 50 yards out for the Wolves. No score here. Early going, about 6 minutes in. 18th ranked Tusculum against the Newberry Wolves. Tusculum sitting in the number 18th. And a hard fall by Guillermo Liscano, it looks like, yes. So he gets up a little gingerly. It'll be a corner kick for Newberry. Looks like Eric Brody taking that one for the Wolves. Sends it to the top of the box and a high kick as Went tries to one-time it from 28 yards out, but ball took a little bit of a hop and sails way high up into the net behind the goal. Long cross, but that would be hauled in by Alvarez, and quickly up come the Pioneers. Linkus, Prosh, but a little bit too far. Newberry still with possession. Sends it wide to Went. Went crosses it to the middle, but that will be kicked away by Sayre, and it'll be another corner kick for Newberry. So Newberry has come out on the attack here in the first 7 minutes. So yet a corner, a little too high, go over the end line, it'll be a goal kick for Tusculum. After today's match, the Pioneers are back in action on Tuesday, so a quick turnaround for TC. Step out of conference play for the final time this regular season. They take on Trevecca Nazarene. Match time 6 o'clock here at Pioneer Field. We'll have all the action for you here at TusculumPioneers.com and on the Pioneer Sports Network. And Tusculum will be on the road on Saturday at Coker before returning home for a couple of home matches against Brevard and Mars Hill. And that'll be another quick turnaround for TC, playing Brevard on Wednesday, and then a quick turnaround taking on Mars Hill on Friday night, a rare Friday night tilt. And that'll be a foul, and Tusculum will get a free kick for an advantageous spot, about 30 yards out. So it looks like Linkus will be taking the kick. A liner headed away. Newberry gets away with a handball, but Tusculum will get the throw in. Giorgio sends it over to Dunn. Dunn trying to get to Prosh, but just a little bit too far. Coming way off the line is Lascano. And a long ball down the line. Pedro will come up with it, or let it go, and then Alvarez will gather it in. Done. Header by Linkus, and it goes in. So Tyler Linkus puts the Pioneers on the board. They draw first blood here in the early going of the first half. Credit the assist to Dallas Dunn, and Tusculum has taken a 1-0 lead. So the goal by Linkus, his second of the season. Credit the assist to Dallas Dunn, picks up his fourth save, his fourth helper of the season. Gets him tied for the team lead with Rocco Mena. Back comes Newberry on the counter, but Tusculum will kick it away. So Tusculum taking a 1-0 lead on the second goal of the season by Tyler Linkus. Long through ball to Linkus as he is on. Makes a nice move. That is blocked on the shot, but Pioneer still in possession. Hernandez back to Linkus. Hernandez goes long. Flag is not up. Newberry is calling for it to be up, but it's not. Through ball trying to find the head of Anderbach. Ball is still free. Looked like DeGiorgi with the shot, and that was saved. So Tusculum has taken the 1-0 lead with the goal by Tyler Linkus. Nice little chip cross by Dallas Dunn to set up Linkus, as Dixon had zero chance on making the save on that one, as he goes to the low near corner. Yeah. So the Pioneers were several shots on goal so far. Newberry came out on fire on the early course of play, winning several corner kicks. But Tusculum is broken free with the first goal of the match by Tyler Linkus. That ball goes off the Chris Linker Memorial Athletic Training Tiki Hut. We have a foul on Newberry, and Tusculum will get a free kick from a dangerous spot. They line up the wall, but shot by Linkus goes wide as his bid to get goal number two of the match. Sails wide right. It'll be a goal kick for Newberry. Again, Tusculum leading 1-0. Tyler Linkus with the goal in the 12th minute, assisted by Dallas Dunn. Tusculum's outshot Newberry in early going, 3-1. Including two shots on goal. And Pioneer Man trying to follow up the women, as they won in dramatic fashion, 1-0 over Newberry's women in double overtime. Match winner by Peyton DeHart. A little over 4 minutes remaining in the second overtime period as they improve to 4-0-1 in conference play and move into sole possession of second place. Tusculum right now locked in a dead tie with Wingate. There's a foul, and Newberry will get a nice chance here just outside the penalty area. Yeah, I stand corrected. Tusculum is in second place in the conference standings. Of course, they've got one game in hand, so to keep pace with Wingate, who's a perfect 7-0, 5-0 in league play, the Pioneers will have to win. They're off to a good start, have an early 1-0 lead over the Wolves. Eric Brody and Klaus Leland, and a tipped away by Alvarez. Looks like he slipped a little bit. As the Wolves are going to the far post. So another corner kick, fourth of the match for Newberry. That's punched out by Alvarez, and he is down. And he'll need to get up. Alvarez got banged up pretty severely in that Pfeiffer match, and he's holding his back once again. And he's really in a lot of pain as the trail of play continues. And they're going to go ahead and kick this one out as Alvarez is down, and looks like we'll stop the match as Erica Pomona will make the long run to check on the Pioneer goalkeeper. He went down in the second half against Pfeiffer. As it looks like he collided or caught a knee in the back. He caught some serious physicality there from Newberry, so that he is down and getting checked out. And don't see anybody warming up. Looks like Ashley Elsie is coming off the bench, and looks like he's going to be getting ready just in case he is needed. Alvarez has played every minute for the Pioneers this season. So Alvarez getting checked. Seems to be walking around very gingerly. But it looks like he's going to stay in. I believe so. So Alvarez will stay in the game. The Pioneers kicked it out. I'm sure that will be a throw in by Newberry, or they will just go ahead and throw it in and then kick it. So we're back under action. Tusculum leading 1-0. Nice through ball by Dunn, trying to catch DeGiorgi on the move, but Dixon comes off the line, gathers the ball in just inside the area, and we'll kick it away. Something opposing keeper, especially in the first half, and especially this time of the day with the sun setting right in their face, and also not knowing this Pioneer pitch can get a little bit hard, so that ball's a high ball coming in like that, it will bounce very, very high off this turf. When I say turf, I mean grass that's hard like turf. But the field conditions have held up very, very well. The Tusculum facility management staff has done an outstanding job in regards to maintaining the facility. And you're talking about facility in the fall takes, you know, three sports playing on it, women's soccer, men's soccer, and football. And in the spring, you have men's and women's lacrosse who are on the field. So hats off to the facility management folks for a yeoman's job. Tusculum leading 1-0. We're about 20 minutes into the match. Tusculum leading 1-0 on the goal in the 12th minute by Tyler Linkus. His second of the season. Kicked high in the air by Pedro, trying to go long to Dunn. Dunn will let that go, and it'll be a throw-in for Tusculum. Dunn recorded his fourth assist of the season on that Linkus goal. Nice through ball, goes wide. Not sure if that was a pass or a shot by Andebach, but be a goal kick nonetheless for Newberry, with the Wolves trailing 1-0. Sarah chases that down. Pedro off to Andebach. Sends it to middle to Hernandez. Hernandez goes wide to Lescano. The original 11 in for TC. Prosh got a little unlucky as that rolled up, hit him in the head, and caught a part of his arm. So it'll be a handball and a foul. They will let that go, and down goes Hernandez very, very hard, but earns a free kick for TC. Hernandez with the match winner in overtime, his second overtime winner of the season. But none more exciting than the blast he took from 30 yards out. There's a chip to DeGiorgi. DeGiorgi goes wide to Linkus. Pedro to Prosh. Andebach. Andebach out in the middle. Sends it out to Hernandez. Hernandez comes the other way. Sends it wide to Linkus. Linkus to Prosh. Prosh with a shot. Dixon gathers it in for the save. And back comes Newberry. Turnover by Newberry. A long high shot by DeGiorgi. DeGiorgi with the team leader in shots, points, and goals this season. 6 goals, 1 match winner. Got an assist, 13 points, and again, 28 shots. Started in all 9 matches for the Pioneers this year. In Tusculum leading early, 1-0 over to Newberry Wolves. We're live from Tusculum College's Pioneer Field here at the Neiswanger Sports Complex. Newberry with a good chance here. Shot by, tipped away. It's like Bucco with the shot, and that's knocked away by Alvarez. So Newberry taking their fifth corner. They've only got three shots, but they got five corners today. That's headed away. Newberry still has possession. Still on the move. That's chipped out by Prosh. And here comes Tusculum. Tusculum will slow it down a little bit, gather it in, get some numbers. So they try to move it forward. On the back to Prosh. Prosh, nice through ball to DeGiorgi. DeGiorgi, as he is dispossessed by Crochel. But Dunn comes up with it, and he'll earn a corner. So Pioneers are out shooting Newberry 5-3. Will pick up their first corner of the match. Lincoln sends it in low. Head away. Hernandez gathers it in for Tusculum. Hernandez goes down to be a foul, and Tusculum will get a free kick just outside the box here. Leading 1-0, 17 minutes remaining here in the first half. Header shot just high by Andre DeGiorgi. Be a goal kick, and we'll have a Newberry sub coming in. Be Juan Villa Bailey, sophomore from Charleston, South Carolina. Here come the Wolves. That's Brian. Brian is dispossessed, and back come the Pioneers. That's Dunn. Thank you. Here come the Pioneers. Chip shot over to DeGeorge, and he finishes. So Hernandez with the assist, and DeGeorge with his seventh goal of the season, and Tusculum leads 2-0.
Tusculum goal, scoring number 7, Andre DeGeorge. Assist number 9, Isai Hernandez. And number 16, Ivan Andaban.
So a double assist for the Pioneers. Hernandez and Andaban get the assist. And the Tusculum Pioneers have taken a 2-0 lead. Looks like Jonathan Speaker is going to be checking in for Tusculum. I believe the line judge is going to come over and check to make when DeGeorge went in, his momentum carried him in and pretty much dislodged a big part of the net. So we're going to have to do a little bit of repair. Which may take a little while. Looks like a lot of the netting got dislodged, and I always wonder why he's the only one who can repair this. You would think there'd be a little few more people who aren't doing anything. Got a little bit of an equipment delay. As they're doing some repairs on the goal. Again, Andre DeGeorge getting his team leading 7th goal of the season on assist from Andaban and Hernandez, but when he chipped in the goal, his momentum carried him into the net, and basically, I mean, just out of reaction, he grabbed on to anything he could and dislodged a lot of the netting. So doing some repairs right now on the net, on the goal, that is. Trying to make sure the net is secure. Again, Tusculum leading 2-0. 13 minutes, 42 seconds remaining in the first half. have subs coming in for the Wolves. As for the Pioneers, Andres Cavam coming in. Looks like he's coming in for DeGiorgi. And again, I saw Jonathan Speaker looking to check in, but I believe he was one of the folks on the maintenance staff in regards to fixing the net. That's a pretty good job by the academic All-American. And if you're scoring at home, and I hope you are, also a little instant replay review. Great thing having here with YouTube and our 3D video. Also credit and assist on that first goal also by Dunn along with Fabian Prosh. So Pioneers with two goals but four assists, and we got a Newberry player that's down. And they'll let that go, and we're going to have stoppage of play, and we'll have a Newberry player down. We had a little bit of an injury delay early going to Jorge Alvarez, the goalkeeper for Tusculum, but he seems to be okay. They're going to send the trainer out. Looks like Juan Villabelli, who checked in just a few moments ago, looks like he's the injured Wolf. Down on the pitch. 12:49 remaining here in the first half, with Tusculum leading 2-0. Next up for the Pioneers, they'll be in action on Tuesday night when they take on Trevecca Nazarene. Match time 6 o'clock here at Pioneer Field. Newberry will be back home on Wednesday. They'll be in a conference battle with their South Carolina counterpart, Anderson. The match begins at 4 o'clock from the Smith Row Complex. Next weekend, Tusculum will be at Coker. While Newberry will stay at home, they'll be hosting Lincoln Memorial. After that Lincoln Memorial match, Newberry will be on a three-match road swing with matches against Queens, Brevard, Mars Hill, before returning home to take on Lenoir Rhine. So a nice round of applause by the Pioneer faithful. Newberry has a nice contingent here at today's match. Once again, we're very glad to have you with us on this Sunday afternoon, South Atlantic Conference men's soccer action, Tusculum and Newberry. The score holds up. Tusculum could move into a tie for first place with Wingate. Tusculum sitting at second place all by themselves with 12 points with a 4-0 record. Then there is a three-way logjam for third place with 9 points between Lenora and Coker and Catawba. Newberry finds itself in 11th place with 3 points. And Anderson University, the only team without a win this season in conference play, 4-5 and overall. Yesterday results, Wingate scored an early goal and they made it stand up at 1-0 win over Lincoln Memorial. LR got a big win, 3-0 over Queens. Coker won 2-0 over Mars Hill. Then a couple of double overtime results. Catawba knocking off Brevard 1-0, and then Carson Newman getting a thrilling 2-1 win at McCown Field over in Jefferson City. That's where Tusculum will be later this month. Still very early, a lot of soccer to be played, but that match coming up on October 29th at Wingate is setting up, could be, for the conference championship. Again, very early going. Can't get ahead of yourselves. A lot of quality teams in the league, but only two nationally ranked teams so far are Tusculum and Wingate. Tusculum most certainly will, this result can hold, will move up the poll ranked 18th in the country for a second consecutive week. A lot of the folks around Tusculum scratching their head and why that was the case, but as you said, if you just keep taking care of business on the field, you will, the polls will take care of themselves. With that impressive result, Panthers were named the Southland Conference Team of the Week. New award is being presented by the conference office. Long through ball, might be a little bit too far. And it will be, so it'll be throw in deep in the corner for Tusculum. Under 10 minutes remaining in the first half, Tusculum leading 2-0. Goes by Tyler Linkus in the 12th minute. And Andre DeGiorgi in the 32nd. Rocco Mena into the lineup for Tusculum. Was to come during that injury. Here comes Lascano. Lascano. His shot goes wide. Have another sub for Newberry. Reyes wide, that's deflected. And the Pioneers on the counter, that's Hernandez. Sends it wide over to Mena. Mena to Andebach, back to Mena. Mena at the top with a shot from distance, but too far and a little wide. So for Tusculum, their ninth shot of the match. Linkus to Gavam. Proch sends that one in just a little bit too much pace. Trying to get it back to Gavam or Linkus. Linkus put the Pioneers up 1-0 with his goal in the 12th minute. Then Andre DeGiorgi added the second goal for TC. And the double assist by Hernandez and Andebach. A little over 6 minutes remaining here in the first half. Tusculum leading 2-0. Mena wide to the ball. Kavam with a shot, but just not enough. Couldn't get enough boot on it. And Dixon gathers that in. So great passes by the Pioneer offense. As Kavam comes up empty, it's still a 2-0 lead for TC. Where Dixon records his fourth save of the match. We enter the 41st minute, Tusculum leading 2-0. Seventh foul of the match for TC. Evens the tally sheet in that department at 7-7. Long pass trying to find ahead of Davis Bryan, but just a little bit too high. As Alvarez lets that go, and it'll be a goal kick for Tusculum, another sub for Newberry. As Bryan will come out. Mitch Paraga will come in for the Wolves. Long pass to Kavam as he's on. Makes a move. Shot, it just goes wide. So two great chances for Kavam here in the last couple of minutes. That one might have been his best opportunity. So he was 1-on-1 with the keeper and try to put a shot to just inside the far post, but just a little bit too far wide. And you're set to behind the back. Went wide to Mena. Long pass to Kavam. Once again, he is on. Chips it over and tipped away by Dixon. Another beautiful save by Dixon, looking very sharp in goal. So he's keeping his team in this match. Pioneer's getting several chances here in the last 5 minutes. So the Pioneers will get a corner kick. 2:15 remaining here in the first half. Chipped away. Opportunity for Newberry on the counter. They send it wide, and the Speedy Race comes up with it. Ball is still in play, and here comes Tusculum. It was 2-on-4. About to say Kavam is about 3 yards off on that one. And he knew it as soon as the ball left the foot, so. But the clock is still ticking. It's a turnover, and a lot of time is ticking away.
1 minute remaining first half, 1 minute.
I was about to say, I think it was Newberry, because I think just a little miscommunication, so it was definitely an offside. So less than a minute remaining here in the first half, with Tusculum leading 2-0. Pioneers have looked sharp here. Linkus comes up. 30 seconds remaining. Chip shot finds Kavam. Unlucky there. Tusculum still on. But here comes Newberry. 20 seconds remaining. And they've got numbers. Here comes a foot race, but coming way off his line is Alvarez. The last 10 seconds are counting down.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
And that is the end of the first half. So we'll be back after this 15-minute intermission. Again, Tusculum leading 2-0 over Newberry. This is Pioneer Soccer on the Pioneer Sports Network and TusculumPioneers.com. Hi, everybody. Dom Donnelly with you from... We're back once again at Pioneer Field. Tusculum leading 2-0 here in the early going of the second half. First half stats, Tusculum out shooting Newberry 11-3. Tusculum out shooting Newberry 11-3. Newberry owned a 5-2 advantage in corner kicks. Newberry goalkeeper Brad Dixon made 4 saves in the first half, while Jorge Alvarez recorded 2 saves of the 6 shots he faced. The 3 shots he faced, 2 of which were on frame. Even in fouls, 7 each for Tusculum and Newberry. So we approach the 49th minute, Tusculum leading 2-0. Goal in the 12th minute by Tyler Linkus, his second of the season, assisted by Dallas Dunn and Fabian Prosch. And then second goal of the match came in the 32nd minute, scored by Andre DeGiorgi, his seventh of the season, assisted by Hernandez and Andebach. And that's where we stand. Tusculum had several other opportunities, especially a couple of shots by Andre Skavam, had a couple of shots on goal. One that just went barely wide. So Tusculum leading 2-0, but probably could be more. Again, they owned an 11-3 shot advantage in the first half. And Tusculum has a very tough stretch of matches, a lot of matches in a short period of time. 48 hours from now, they will be in action here at Pioneer Field against Trevecca Nazarene. 6 o'clock match time. That's Kavam. That'll be last touchback of him, so that'll be a goal kick. Thought that was going to be a corner, but that not the case, so. Pretty good hustle by the Wolves. Eric Brody. Quentin Eisner. Eisner staying in the game after coming in off the bench in the first period. Bro sends it wide. Goes all the way over to Linkus on the far side. Unable to possess. Be a throw in. But intercepted by Linkus. In for the Pioneers to start this second half. Looks like the back four are about the same. And Hernandez is in along with Dunn. And that's Mena. Correction, Dunn is not in. And it's Proche, so. That's Proche. Goes wide to Linkus. Nice stop by Linkus. He takes a long shot from distance, and Dixon makes a beautiful save. Dixon has had the opportunities. He's had a lot of opportunities. Panthers trying to go in with a quick start, but referee Mark Schumacher will not have anything to do with that, so. And it will whistle them back, and we are. Now we're ready to go. Ball's officially moved, put back into play. Back comes Newberry, trailing 2-0 here in the early going of the second half. That's chipped away by Sayre. Long kick, and that will go. Nope, they will say that it is in out of play. As the linesman was, assistant referee was right on it. I believe that's Tyler Metcalf. Scott Smiles is on the near side here. Linkus tried to send that one wide, but that is deflected and be a throw in for TC. Tusculum 2, Newberry nothing. 35 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the second half. Pioneers trying to match their best start in school history at 9-0 with no ties. There's been a lot of good teams at this school. Tony Kostanka took a team to the Final Four past decade. Brett Teach followed suit in 2008. That team won a school record 20 games. made it all the way to the national quarterfinals. Lost a heartbreaker to Tampa right here at Pioneer Field. And we've got some... Getting a little loud here at Pioneer, getting a little chippy. As Guillermo Lascano picked up the ball, would not put it down, so Newberry with the free kick. Something you don't want to see from the captain. Back comes Rocco Mena. Mena with a shot. Chipped, deflected by Dixon, long shot. And a long high shot that almost goes over the roof of the indoor practice facility here at Tusculum. So a nice save by Dixon on the shot by Mena. Approach through ball to Mena. Mena goes wide. Header shot blocked by Dixon. That was Kavam on the shot. Tusculum still with the ball. Great possession by TC, but great defense by Dixon. It's been a shooting gallery here the last three minutes for the Newberry netminder, but he has been solid in goal. This could be a 6-0 game right now, but Dixon has looked outstanding between the pipes. Made several saves, several acrobatic saves. So Pioneers have put on the pressure trying to extend this 2-0 lead. Hernandez, that shot is blocked. Here comes the Wolves as they try to counter. And that is about a yard off was Cameron Proven. Just a yard, maybe about a half yard if you want to get technical, but chip to Lascano. Beautiful, beautiful pass to Kavam, but just solid good defense by Newberry. So we've got some communication going on here, and it looks like maybe the keeper crossed the line, maybe, or we'll see what it is. Yep, that's what they're going to point out. Guillermo Lascano wants that ball badly, and these guys don't get to touch this thing very much, but needs to put it down, but it will be a free kick. Looks like for Tusculum. And of course, he'll get the 10 yards, so. So the conclave continues here just outside the just outside the box. So the ball is just outside the 18. And the box is formed here. And if this football field is lined, they're only giving him 8 yards. So I might be missing something here, but we'll see who gets to take it. Could be one of three people. Looks like it's going to be Linkus, shot and a save by Dixon. So executed very well. It was on goal, and Dixon just came up with a great save. And Newberry hanging around, very dangerous. They always say the most dangerous lead to have is a 2-0 lead, and Tusculum has got that right now. Ball comes way out, tipped away and by Alvarez, and Pioneers will try to counter. Kavam gets a head on it, but nobody home, and Newberry will gather it in. But the Pioneers applying pressure. I think they figure if they can add this third goal, it would be the backbreaker, but Newberry's hanging around. Tusculum leading 2-0. Under 30 minutes remaining here in the second half. I would say it's a shock. The lights are coming on here at Pioneer Field, but know the guy that turned them on. Approaching 6:22 here on the East Coast. Again, glad to have you with us wherever you're watching. Here at TusculumPioneers.com and on YouTube. Tusculum College and Newberry College. Tusculum looking to complete the soccer sweep today. The Pioneer women winning 1-0 in double overtime on the Peyton DeHart goal. The Tusculum men leading 2-0 here in the second half with about 28 minutes remaining in regulation. Tusculum has been on the attack, But again, Newberry looking really, really been very, very sharp defensively, especially with the play of their goalkeeper, Brad Dixon. Talking about Dixon, he's recorded 8 saves. 4 in the first half, he's got 4 here in the early part of the second. Coming back into the contest will be, looks like, DeGiorgi and Dunn. Seeing his first action of the day will be Sean Foster. For Foster, it's going to be his fifth appearance this season. Being challenged by and dispossessed by Linkus. Be a throw in for Tusculum, and Pioneers will bring in the subs. Again, DeGiorgi and Dunn back in. Sean Foster making his first appearance of the match, as is the hero, one of the heroes from Wednesday night's match, and Jonathan Speaker. Just wanted to make sure it didn't. And Speaker did a number switch. He wore number 9 last year, and he switched to 23, which was worn by Linkus. High shot, little high, good touch, but just a little bit off mark. And we have a sub for Newberry. Clock continues to tick, 24 minutes remaining in regulation with Tusculum leading 2-0. Scoring opportunity. Here comes a block, a team save. Credit that one to Guillermo Lescano. That'll be a corner kick for Newberry, but Alvarez came off his line, could not gather in the rebound, and credit today to Guillermo Lescano, comes up with the team save. But a corner kick for Newberry is there. Again, getting outshot, but they are still hanging around. So a yellow card been issued to, looks like, Isai Hernandez. First booking of the match for either team. So 21-17 remaining in regulation. And coming way off the line, staying on side was Proven. Here come the Pioneers. That's DeGiorgi. He's dispossessed. Here comes Newberry. They've got numbers. Speaker. Just a little bit of a heavy touch, trying to get it over to Dunn on the near side. And that's Leland, taken by Dunn. It'll be a Tusculum throw-in. Tusculum out shooting Newberry 16-6. But Newberry has, at the course of play of late, Proven as he and Sear collide, and Sear is down. Sear trying to get up, and he does. It'll be a corner kick for Newberry. Yeah, shot 16-6, but this will be their sixth corner of the match. Ball is free, and it'll be a foul. And Alvarez is hurt again. So the clock has stopped with 18:50 remaining in the match. Tusculum leading 2-0 over Newberry. Foster with the ball. Foster goes wide to Lascano. Guillermo. Gets it off to Speaker. Speaker to Dunn. Lascano. Over to Andebach. Back to Dunn. Here comes Dunn. Wide. Trying to do a cross. Trying to find DeGiorgi. Maybe Hernandez, but and the one thing that will be battling for Alvarez probably for the next couple of moments is he's battling the sun as it's setting to the west, and he is staring right into it. It's a very tough sun. Any match that starts after about 5 o'clock, this is what you're going to be facing when the sun going down. You know, at the baseball stadium, the left fielders are just always battling this. It's pretty tough. You can just tell looking at Lascano, he couldn't barely see it. Clock is stopped, and that'll be an instant card, even though the impact was not severe. But still, you don't touch the goalie, so Cameron Provin picks up the card, second card of the match for either team. Hernandez picked up one in the early here in the half. So the booking goes in, and Provin will come out. He'll be replaced. Again, the impact was not very severe on Alvarez, who has been known to embellish. We will admit that. Again, you do not touch the goalie when he has the ball like that, so. Kicked away, but Newberry comes up with it. Nice ball, but coming up with it and chipping away is Alvarez. He is still down, but one of the Pioneers is down, and that will stop the clock, and we've got someone down in this. We have another stoppage, 16:44. I believe that might be Sarah, and hopefully it's just a cramp. He's reaching down towards his left leg. So Tusculum leading in shots, 16-7, 10-4 on shots on goal. 8 saves by Brad Dixon, 4 for Alvarez. Newberry with 7 corners they've won. They got a throw in here. Fouls, again, been a little chippy, 12 fouls each, including a yellow card apiece. So that's where we stand. Tusculum leading 2-0 with goals by Linkus and DeGiorgi. Pioneers looking to improve to 9-0 on the season. They are 16 minutes and 44 seconds away from doing so. Standing in their way are the Newberry Wolves, who are not going down without a fight. Ball is batted around. Foster keeps it in play, finds DeGiorgi. Z finds a speeding Jonathan Speaker. He heads it over to Hernandez. Hernandez get a shot off, but Dixon again, another save, his 9th of the match. And back comes Newberry on the counter. And that'll be a handball charged against Newberry in the box. Oh, don't. I was about to say, the clock was stopped at 15:37. But ball was kicked into play, and they played for a little while, but the referee went over to talk with Tusculum head coach Alan Vital. Coach Vital was a little bit perturbed by the fact that Sarah, who came off with the injury, was waiting to get back in as the Pines were playing down a man. And he was never waved on and had that problem in the women's match. But Sarah is back on, and we are underway once again. That's on the back. Kicked in by Lascano. DeGeorgie gets off a shot. Not a lot on it, but Dixon gathers it in for his 10th save. And back the other way come the Wolves. Just over 14 and a half minutes remaining here in regulation. Shot, and a beautiful save by Alvarez. She gets a fingertip on it. He yells at his back line. Get the turnover, but Vallejos, what a shot. Just got that one off, and it's tipped, and so it's going to be a corner kick for Newberry. The referee is stopping the clock almost on everything. Low corner kick. Not a lot of quality on that one, but that'll be kicked away and it'll be a throw-in for Newberry. A lot of chirping going on between the teams. And I believe Mark Schumacher has pretty much had enough of both. I always say when that gets to the case, that's when you go ahead and you start handing out cards, and that will fix that. Foster to Georgie. Nice give and go by the Wolves. Here comes Newberry, trailing 2-0. They've been putting a lot of pressure here in the last couple of moments, trying to cut this deficit in half. Not sure if that was going to be a shot by Leland or not, but that goes high, and that will be a goal kick for TC. 12 minutes, just over 12 minutes remaining in regulation. Tusculum leading 2-0. Goals by Linkus and DeGeorgie coming in the 12th and 32nd minute, respectively. Foul against Tusculum, be a free kick for Newberry. Sliding on a ball was looked like Hernandez. That'll be kicked into the stands and Can't tell if it was out of play or not. Say, if you're going to kick it into the stands, keep it in the stands. Don't let it go out of the stadium. As always say, somebody's got to go get it. Long cross. That's a Hernandez. Off to DeGiorgi. DeGiorgi trying to give it back to Hernandez, but that is intercepted, and back comes Newberry. 10.5 minutes remaining. And the offsides flag is up, and Dallas Dunn is saying what happened, and it was him who was the man marked off. So I know he's looking, but we could see it from up here. He was definitely off by about a couple of yards. Done with the defense. But back come the Wolves. Proven. Trying to do a little give and go, and that will be kicked away. Looks like it was kicked right into the Newberry women's soccer section. They are sticking around watching their fellow student athletes play. Tusculum women winning 1-0 in double overtime. Newberry's women are 3-7, but they didn't look like a 3-7 team today. They looked very, very solid, and it's very unfortunate for them to go into 1-4. They just look like a 1-4 team. I'll be kicked away, and that will be a corner kick for Newberry. Yet another one. Ninth of the match. So under 8.5 minutes remaining. Kick low. Be a goal kick for Tusculum. Shots are 18-8 in favor of Tusculum. 10 of those shots saved by Brad Dixon. Jorge Alvarez has recorded 5 saves. He's made some beauties here in the second half. Alvarez and the Pioneers looking for the fourth shutout of the year. In the 18th meeting between these two schools, Tusculum leading the all-time series 15-0-2. They've won the last 7 meetings, including 11-0 all-time here at Pioneer Field. Dixon with 64 saves this season, including 10 in this match. Mike Alvarez. Dixon has played every minute this year for the Wolves. Long ball. And Alvarez falls on it. Under 6 minutes remaining. After today, the Pioneers will be hosting Trevecca Nazarene on Tuesday. They're playing five during a stretch where they're playing five of six matches at home. They're right in the middle of this midseason homestand. Tusculum's won their first four matches here on the home pitch. Wins over King, Queens, Lenoir Ryan, and Pfeiffer. Looking for win number five. They can hold on to this match. Leading 2-0, under 5 minutes remaining. This result stands. Tusculum will move back into a tie for first place with Wingate with 15 points, both sitting at 5-0 in league play. Both are undefeated. Overall, Wingate is 7-0. Tusculum currently 8-0, looking to go to 9-0 for only the second time in school history. So the Pioneers just trying to keep possession and try to run some clock out, but didn't do a good job there. So they're trying to send it at the far sideline. Tusculum not looking crisp these last 5 minutes. Newberry only possession, but just trying to maintain possession, try to hold on this 2-0 lead with less than 3 minutes remaining. Dunn goes wide to Lescano. Back out to Dunn. Dunn to Ondebach. Trying to find Hernandez, but he can't hold on. And back comes Newberry. High ball, punched out by Alvarez, and they're going to call the foul. The assistant referee called it. And words are being discussed again. Getting tempers flying here late in the match. So a yellow card has been assessed. Second one of the match for Newberry. Looks like Bucco will be getting the booking. So 1:57 remaining in the match. Tusculum leading 2-0. speaker to Anabak, over to Foster. Foster with a shot, goes wide. Certainly not his best, but good to see Sean in the lineup getting some minutes. Seeing the field for the fifth time this season. Got a minute, a little over a minute left in the match.
1 minute remaining in the second half. 1 minute.
Match just has seemed to take an eternity to play, especially the second half. One's been marred by fouls, some cards. But some outstanding goalkeeping by both Brad Dixon and Jorge Alvarez. And we've got a whistle, and it'll be another card. Now we'll go to Jonathan Speaker. And Speaker needs to just get out of the way. 36.8 seconds remaining. Speaker picks up a late booking. And I think he's looking at it, and he's thinking, I made a mistake there. Stopped a great scoring chance. Headed away by Speaker. Back come the Pioneers. They have numbers. Here comes DeGiorgi. Puts a shot up and in. So a goal by Andre DeGiorgi. His second of the match in Tusculum has put this one away with a late goal. With 22.9 seconds remaining, and the Pioneers lead 3-0. So Hernandez DeGiorgi picks up. DeGiorgi picks up his second goal of the match, his eighth of the season. Hernandez picks up his second assist of the match. So a nice week for Hernandez with a goal and two assists. Here comes Tusculum. Five, looking for more.
Four, three, two, one.
And that's the end of the match. Your final score, Tusculum wins 3-0. So for the first time since 2004, the Pioneers have opened the season 9-0.
The Pioneers will be back home Tuesday night. Please launch Rebecca Manager in the non-conference match beginning at 6 p.m.
So your final score, Tusculum 3, Newberry nothing. Tyler Linkus got things started for the Pioneers with a goal in the 12th minute. Then at the 31-18 mark, Andre DeGiorgi scored. And that's the way it stayed until the last minute of the game. And Andre DeGiorgi picks up his second goal of the match, his eighth of the season. And Tusculum now improves to 9-0 on the season, 5-0 in league play. So we'll be back with you in about 48 hours as the Pioneers welcome Trevecca Nazarene. 6 o'clock kickoff between Tusculum and the Trojans of Trevecca Nazarene. I'd like to thank you for watching today's matches. Tusculum gets the sweep over Newberry. The Tusculum women win 1-0 in double overtime, while the Tusculum men have just posted a 3-0 win over Newberry. Again, I'd like to thank you for watching tonight's matches. And again, thank you for watching. This is Dom Donnelly signing off for the final time. Again, your final score, Tusculum 3, Newberry nothing from Pioneer Field.